Our strategy's main goals are to manage financial resources allocation to the portfolio of different strategic business units the overall company is made of, while at the same time driving the decisions on whether to enter new business areas and or grow, hold position, or divest from the business areas already covered. Corporate strategy's formulation should then start with the analysis of the current company's portfolio, that is, the mapping of the products of a company, which allows to understand if such portfolio is balanced or not from a financial and strategic perspective. In order to support this process, the most widespread tools used by corporate managers are the so-called portfolio matrices. The basic idea behind such matrices is to represent a diversified company's BA in a simple visual model to support corporate strategy definition. These tools start from the following key assumption: long-term profitability of each SBU in a portfolio depends on business area attractiveness and SBU competitive positioning in the business area. But eventually, what does this mean? Well, this is nothing but a synthesis of external and internal strategy analysis. For each SBU in a portfolio, we are evaluating market attractiveness, which results from external analysis, and competitive positioning and advantage coming from internal analysis. Portfolio matrices are hence a sort of SWOT analysis in brief, where we map not a single strategic business unit, but the corporate portfolio as a whole. Hence, the main objectives of a portfolio matrix are to analyze the competitive advantage coming from the managing of a SBU's portfolio, to support the choice of a business portfolio, corporate strategy definition, to provide some guidelines to SBUs for the definition of their own business strategy, and to analyze the corporate strategies of competitors.